Just 10 days ago, Honiara was alight. Protesters calling for the Prime Minister to resign.
Motion number 18, motion of no confidence.
Today, Manase Sogavare faced a vote of no confidence. The motion filed by the opposition leader, who says the unrest was due to long-standing issues of inequality.
Sir, the vast majority of our young people are unemployed. Our people are asking how long, Mr. Speaker, must this continue? How long does the Prime Minister need to implement serious reforms to ensure sustainable jobs are created out of the dwindling resources?
At least four government MPs crossed the floor.
Honourable Prime Minister.
But an impassioned Prime Minister spoke for over an hour.
Burning down of Chinatown and business infrastructures in Honiara to force the narrow interest of one group, Mr. Speaker, is absurd. A dangerous precedent would be set. It means that in the future, if people do not like the Prime Minister, they would force him or her to resign by protesting, rioting, looting and burning the city.
And in the end, the incumbent had the votes.
The motion is therefore defeated.
Manase Sogavare is a political survivor.
May God bless Sogavare.
He's been elected on four separate occasions, the first amid the Civil War in 2000. In 2006, he returned, the country again ablaze with riots. He took over from a controversial leader, Snyder Rini. Mr. Rini's election sparked riots, with allegations his run for office was aided by the Chinese government. Mr. Sogavare's third term saw him oversee the end of the Australian-led peacekeeping mission. He signed a deal that meant he could call on Australia at times of crisis. It was this agreement that he enacted last month when the riots broke out.
He's a household name in the country and is talked about even when he's not Prime Minister. He has a reputation for being passionate, but a divisive figure in Solomon Islands politics.
Australian officers will remain in the country for several weeks. Troops are helping to quell any flare-ups in protests following the vote. Lucy Murray, SBS World News.